We're going road racing on RPM tonight. Winston Cup Warriors head west to the twists and turns of Sears Point. Jeff Gordon is reigning king of the road with 5 straight road course wins. Kyle Petty, starting in the front row, is the sentimental favorite. Kart takes its road show to Portland International Raceway. Teammates Helio Castroneves and Gilles DeFerrin look to hold their 1-2 starting positions right to the finish line. But don't count out Juan Montoya, 4 points leader Paul Tracy. The Busch Series hits the road at Watkins Glen, where pole sitter Ron Fellows tries to top his third-place clutch finish. And it's the end of the road for the STP 43 car. We'll salute the distinctive red and blue ride of racing's king one last time. Take a road trip without leaving your chair on RPM tonight, now.
Tonight, I'm Reese Davis. A glorious era ends ingloriously. Kart and Busch coming up in a bit, but we start in California wine country on the road, and even Roger Miller wouldn't confuse Jeff Gordon with a man of means by no means, but he is king of the road. Gordon had won 5 straight road course races, a feat put in greater perspective when you realize the all-time record for road course wins is 6. One of the owners of that record was Rusty Wallace. He was on the pole. This is John Andretti. Last ride in the STP colors, changing up the sponsorship arrangements. Unlucky lap 13. It's Andretti who's having trouble, and he's hot, hot, hot. Andretti walking away from his car, his hopes for one last victory up in smoke. Lap 36, first round of pit stops. Sterling Marlin going in there. Not noted as a road course racer, but he's in first here. Jeff Gordon was second. They come out of there together, and Gordon might have gotten a jump. Sterling had position, and Marlin able to hold him off for a while. Lap 41, Andretti back to battle. He's 25 laps down. He would end up finishing in last place. At the same time, Gordon jumps Marlin and is able to take the lead, but he would nearly have himself a racing deal when Robert Presley, a little squirrely, then all the way around, and Gordon might have helped him. Might not have been Jeff's fault, but he escapes unscathed. 46 to go. Stewart is hurting. Tony Stewart with the flu. John Andretti waiting to hop in that ride for him, but Tony's still racing with Scott Pruitt in second. He's battling Pruitt for first, and Tony would end up getting put in the grass, not observing the 90-degree rule on all fairways, but just 2 corners later, it would be Pruitt who has a racing deal of his own, and he is into the tire jungle where we sell tires for less. Pruitt, who looked as if he had a chance to win this thing, done for the day. Meanwhile, as for Stewart, he's out of the car, and John Andretti's in there in the 20 Pontiac. He ended up coming from 27th to 10th at the finish. Back up front, we restart with 38 laps to go. Kenny Wallace leading for the first time this season. Gordon was in 6th, make that 5th. He gets past Marlin. Boy, those two were together all day, and now Kenny's got a problem. The 24 is there, and he's in front. Jeff Gordon taking the lead and wondering if he had enough gas with 22 to go. Bobby Labonte scores a point on Cappy, puts him down 1 spot. Labonte would finish 4th, Earnhardt 6th. Would Gordon have enough gas? Gordon had to worry about that. Now he only has to worry about finding his way to victory lane. Jeff Gordon getting it done again, throwing beverages around and having a little time of male bonding with the guys. Gordon wins his 6th straight road course race. That obviously is a NASCAR record. He ties for the all-time lead on roadies, and he's won 3 straight at Sears Point. It's Marlin's best finish ever on a road course. Martin's 2nd straight top 5. Labonte matches his best finish at Sears Point. 5 of the last 7 in the top 5 for Rudd. Cappy made up some serious ground after starting way back in the pack. Just DJ's 3rd top 10 and 12 tries at Sears Point. Easily Nadeau and Robbie Gordon's best finishes of the season. Stewart with an assist from Andretti gets a top 10. Gordon earlier said he missed all the boos and all he was getting was a sympathy vote. Now, I know he hasn't been as consistent as in years past, but don't look now, but only 3 guys have won twice on the circuit this season, and Gordon is one of them. The man who moved into 8th on the all-time wins list with number 51 joins Matt Yoakum.
6 straight road course races and 6 straight victories for Jeff Gordon. Congratulations. Another record book run for you.
This is a big win. You know, I mean, to come here to Sears Point and do 3 in a row, and it's kind of, you know, back home for me. This is where I was born, just down the street. Real special because Brian Weitzel's grandmother died this past Friday. So emotional win, a big win for this race team, and it just felt great. You know, sometimes God does amazing things, and you know, things just all worked out right, and we're certainly thankful for all of his blessings.
How concerned were you about fuel?
Oh man, you know, I didn't know what was going to happen. I ran as hard as I possibly could, and I didn't know what you know, what the outcome was going to be. You know, I just didn't want to see a caution because I thought we might be in a little bit of trouble. I used the car pretty hard, and I was trying to conserve fuel a little bit, but trying to keep the car on the racetrack there at the end. So I just wanted to see it go all the way, and I knew my guys in the pits, Robbie and Brian, these guys. I knew they'd get me to the end.
Now off to Daytona, a place where you have a lot of history there too.
Yeah, you know, we won the first night race there and had a little trouble there last year, but we're looking forward to going back. Had a little trouble this year in Daytona, so we've learned a lot since then and won Talladega, so we're pretty excited about it. And this, you know, is just a great way to head into Daytona.
Congratulations, Jeff Gordon, sixth straight on the road courses.
Matt and Jeff, thanks a lot. As Matt mentioned, six in a row, and Gordon has led 51% of the laps in those races. Overall, he has 12 consecutive top 10 finishes on road courses. For noted Super Speedway specialist Sterling Marlin, second on a road course, almost as good as winning.
I'm real pleased with all the guys. You know, they built me a brand new road course car, and it's the first time I've run a standard snout car here, and I always run drop cars, and really drove good all day, and they had good pit stops, and everything just fell our way today.
Well, it was a good run for the Valvoline team. We still got some work to do, but we ran pretty good there at the end. Had a heck of a race with Sterling. He raced clean. We just didn't have enough time to get him.
We just had a great run today. All the guys did a great job in the pits, and car was set up a little tight, too tight in the center, but, you know, then again, it wasn't too bad either, so just like to thank all them. Guys in the motor room did a heck of a job. Good motor. Carried me throughout the day, most of the day, so yeah, fourth place, we'll take it. We're very happy with that.
As I mentioned in the highlight, Kenny Wallace led for the first time this year and gets his best finish of the year. Kyle Petty started on the outside pole, came home 19th. Just the second time this season Kyle's made the top 20. Little E's maiden voyage at Sears Point brings him home 24th, breaking a run of six straight in the top 20. As for the points, Bobby Labonte's ninth top five finish stretches his lead over Cappy to 67 in the points race. Rudd's up a couple of slots. Rusty fell off the page and down to ninth. Gordon remains 10th despite the win. When Elio Castro Neves won last week in Detroit, he ran for the fence like a prisoner paroled from Shawshank. He had been released from the non-winner's jail. The only downside of all this, Castro Neves' celebrations risk becoming more mundane because it appears they'll become more commonplace. The young Brazilian followed his first career win with his second career pole in Rip City, an all Penske front row for the first time since 94, and Elio going for two in a row. Opening lap of the race, Dario Franchitti sees some contact with Kenny Bragg. Franchitti spinning. Max Pappas will be out of the race. Franchitti knocked out of contention. After all of this pileup, I would suggest alternate routes. We have a problem at the interchange. 40 laps to go. This is the points leader. Something broke on Paul Tracy's car that made it go. It was suspension. Tracy out. 38 to go. Roberto Moreno, the race leader, into the pits. He had a problem getting the fuel started. A 19.7-second stop, and that will get you beat. Meanwhile, Gilles DeFerrin takes the lead. 23 laps to go. DeFerrin into the pits. He needs to be fast to get out of there in front of Moreno. 9.6 seconds. That will get it done. DeFerrin just ahead of Moreno. They're the only leaders who don't have to pit again. With 8 laps to go, Castro Neves going to the pits. He leaves DeFerrin and Moreno running 1-2 out there. Castro Neves needed the fuel. 2 laps to go. DeFerrin gets past Patrick Carpentier. He laps him, but Moreno can't get past Carpentier, and he won't yield to oncoming traffic. So on the final lap, Moreno tries again, and again he can't do it. And again it's DeFerrin, and again it's Penske. DeFerrin for the second straight time in Portland. Moreno finished in second place. Christian Fittipaldi, 99, and on Sunday combined to lead all but 4 laps. Patrick Carpentier was not on the lead lap, but he factored heavily in the finish. From Winston Cup, now can they stay in fellowship with road course specialists? We'll check in from the Glen, and more from wine country, where it was less than a vintage day for some, including the pole setter. RPM Tonight motors on after this. He's had a personal best by winning 6 poles, but his average finish in those races nearly 13th. DW's last ride at Sears Point, a 29th. Jeremy Mayfield's momentum didn't help a lot. He did finish 7th at Sears Point last year, but 3 laps back this time. Ron Fellows could be mayor of Watkins Glen if he weren't a Canadian. distance. He owns the place. 1-98 sitting on the pole. Jeff Green, start 10th, finish there. About midway through the race, in trouble in turn one. Tom Hubert spins, goes into the gravel. He would return and finish 37th. Jimmy Johnson had just come out of the pits and suddenly he loses his car. And this is a nasty looking airborne crash into the styrofoam. Another peek at this thing. Johnson totally voted off the island. Fortunately, he would be okay and he would even celebrate. This would have even moved the real Jimmy Johnson's hair.
Went in the braking zone down there and the pedal ended up on the floor. And at that point, I was looking for something to run into to slow me down or do anything. And I got in the grass and hit the racetrack and that was like a jump. And over the sand trap we went and out in the styrofoam. But really got to give Watkins Glen a lot of credit to take the precautions that they have. Because if it was anything else besides styrofoam out there, I'd probably be in an ambulance going somewhere right now.
Certainly thankful that he's not and that he was okay after that wicked looking crash. Here in the caution, the leader Fellows heads for the pits. Dropped to the 20th spot. Now with 22 laps to go, Rubens Racing son PJ Jones bumps into Butch Leisinger trying to take the lead, and Jones had kissed the wall. 21 laps to go. Here comes Ron Fellows. Ron Fellows and Watkins Glen, you do not want to get a mirror full of him. 11 laps to go, side by side of Leisinger, and Fellows would end up retaking the lead on the inside. And on the final lap, Ron Fellows is in control. Chief Inspector Fellows coming across for the victory. The Chief Inspector, does your dog bite? That's not my dog. Cato, is that you? Fellows batting 500, kids. Four career Busch starts, two wins, all at the Glen. It's about time to find out if this guy can drive on an oval tube. Leisinger finishes second. You're wondering where these guys have been? It's their first Busch start, so that makes Kevin Harvick the best in class. Jeff Green was denied his third straight win, but it's most respectable. It's never any shame in losing to Ron Fellows at Watkins Glen.
It was a great race at the end, racing Busch Leisinger, Kevin Harvick. They were strong, and I had to work. Conserve my brakes a little bit, make sure I had lots to get by. But it was that was a lot of work. But that's the kind of racing you like. That was an awesome race.
It's been a great year, and we don't want to just one little bad run. Just top 10, 10th place. A lot of guys would die for a 10th place finish.
Fourth isn't as good as third, but it's better than fifth. I've always enjoyed Watkins Glen. Come up here, race at home. A lot of family and friends here, and I've always enjoyed road racing. And this place has been good to me. A lot of top fives here, and maybe one of these days we'll get a victory out of it.
Well, Green loses just a little bit of his lead and his string of eight straight top five finishes. Other than that, still a most productive day. His margin still a cushy 273 over Todd Bodine. And look at poor Jason Keller in third spot, but 469 points behind Green, who has been amazing with his consistency. Hornaday, baby, drops to sixth after coming home in 36th place. He joins the list of Petty, Allison, and Wallace as the all-time road course kings, but none of those guys got all of their wins in a row. Al Gordon fared so well on the road. Coming up, he had a chance to win this thing or at least finish up front, but a racing deal and what appeared to be a cut tire, and bang, all of a sudden you're into the tire jungle and staring at your eighth finish of 30th or worse. John Andretti had hoped to give STP a bit better send-off, but he had problems as well and finished at the back of the pack. Jeff Gordon has called this a rebuilding year. If that's true, lots of teams would like to have his blueprints. Though Gordon's team has changed dramatically, one thing beats steady as a metronome: the 24 wins on road courses. Nobody ever has won more or more in a row. Matt Yoakum on the latest chapter of the Gordon legend.
Jeff Gordon's first three road course starts were a nightmare, with finishes of 11th, 31st, and 37th. Since then, however, turning left and right has been the Rainbow Warriors' dream, and a nightmare for others. 12 straight top 10s, 6 straight victories, and 3 consecutive wins here at Sears Point.
I love the road courses, and I remember watching, guys like Rusty. I mean, I certainly didn't get a chance to see Richard, but we all know what he's done, and it doesn't surprise me he's done it on the road courses too. But I remember when I first came into NASCAR watching Rusty just really smoke everybody on the road courses, and to know that I've done something that matches up to that, it's pretty incredible.
It feels really good. We were third out here the last 2 years in a row, and Jeff was first, so this morning we were trying to pick the shocks we were going to put on the car, and I said, a normal weekend, if you finish in the top five, you'd feel good, but I said, that's not going to get it today. We got to win.
He's awesome. I mean, the guy's incredible, and we got pretty much similar to setup, and it just takes a while to get used to what he drives. And, you know, later in the race, it really paid off. You know, I was able to pull some pretty quick times, just as quick as, if not quicker than the leaders there at the end. And, you know, we came from 32nd all the way up to 8th.
He really runs good, and he's real good on slick tracks, and he knows how to finesse the accelerator, not get tires lit up and burn the tires off, and, you know, 10 laps later, you're going back, and you hardly ever see him out of shape.
We came close to beating him in 97 at the Glen. We ran with him all day here, so we'll just have to work harder and be better prepared for the Glen this time.
The Winston Cup Series goes back to the Ovals for 4 straight events before returning to Watkins Glen in August. Once again, the competition will have to regroup to make a run at Jeff Gordon, who has won 3 straight in New York. The last guy to win at Watkins Glen before Gordon, Jeffrey Bodine in 1996. In Sonoma, California, I'm Matt Yoakum, ESPN.
Thanks, Matt. It's been an amazing run. The Hot Rods and the Elevator Man, Dan Garrett.